zone today. I actually don't mind if I get stuck for 4 hours in the traffic trying to get out of this place, because it was quite a race to digest and to think about, and it was quite a weekend as well for British sports to see such amazing scenes. For Ferrari, the resurgence continues. Charles Leclerc, what a brilliant drive for him. For Valtteri Bottas, a weekend where he played the team game and picks up another podium. For Lewis Hamilton, a victory for him to take him within one of 100 victories in Formula One. Not since the back end of 2017-2018 had Lewis Hamilton gone five races without a win, but this is first victory since the Spanish Grand Prix, Martin. Closes that gap, as you mentioned. Where do we go from here in this season?
It feels like a total reset. It's almost as if we're starting the season over again, where Red Bull have got a bit of a pace advantage. But these points today for Lewis Hamilton has absolutely reignited this world championship as we head towards the middle parts.
The trophies are given to the drivers and the constructors with the map of the Silverstone track, and on the base, Murray Walker adorning the base and his smiley face. Boy, how Murray Walker would have loved this afternoon.
He would have loved this race. It's a nice touch to put Murray on the trophies.
Absolutely. The Hamilton straights, Murray Walker on the trophies, the sunshine, the smiles. For Max Verstappen, we really hope that he is okay after being taken to hospital for precautionary checks. We'll see how he comes back from this day. Hamilton raises aloft the trophy. British sporting superstar born in England on this Sunday. England did bring it home, and it was on penalties. What a win.
Well, what an incredible race. Late drama, early controversy and drama too. But in the end, for Lewis Hamilton, he has now won 8 British Grand Prix. Along with Schumacher, along with Senna, along with himself at Melbourne, that is a joint record for one man at a venue, but at his home Grand Prix, peerless there for Lewis Hamilton, chasing down Charles Leclerc right at the death. And in the end, it was a haul of 25 points. And he is now narrowed to Max Verstappen to within 8. As we understand it, Max has gone to hospital. He complained of feeling dizzy after that shunt at Cots. We understand he took a 52G impact to his leg, so they are checking him out. We hope he is okay. Damon Hill and Jenson Button watching alongside me. We will come on to that very shortly, but first let's just reflect on the recovery drive from Lewis.
Yeah, I mean, it's never a nice feeling when you've been involved in an incident and then getting the 10-second penalty. But the comeback was fantastic. The last few laps, I mean, he's obviously racing against Charles in a Ferrari, which is, there's a pace difference, but still on it every lap, and it really took his breath away. You could tell when I interviewed him, he's struggling to get his breath back. It was a proper physical race for him.
Yeah, he really was working for that. And you could see, even now, he's still trying to catch his breath, but he had to give everything, and he was totally uncompromising. And you have to say, the sprint, perhaps losing pole position to the sprint has put that fighting spirit into him that he used so aggressively on the first lap. It looked like he wanted that pole position back that he lost yesterday. It was a very, very brave performance, a thrilling finish to the race, and a great weekend all round.
Okay, we'll come back on to the crash between the two championship leaders in a couple of moments' time.